What's going on, YouTube? You're chilling with Pokemon Pokerson. And before we get to the actual episode, I just want to give a quick shout-out to Honest Phil, who did a game review of Bravely Default and actually used my footage. So I'm just going to show a quick 30-second clip of that, and then we can get to the episode.
Finally, I can review the JRPG Bravely Default, which has been said to be the Final Fantasy we always wanted, but never got. The game is about Tis, Anyas, Ringabel, and Idea. Together, they embark on a journey to activate the ancient crystals in order to banish the evil it has been spreading across the land. A kind of story we have pretty much heard in one form or another, but it's the pleasant interaction between those characters and their internal struggles that make for an interesting and engaging story.
So what'd you guys think of it? It was pretty good, right? I mean, I enjoyed it. Last time we killed Adia's master, and, you know, that wasn't cool and stuff, and that left a bad taste in my mouth, honestly. I did not like it. But, I guess it had to be done if we wanted... No, it didn't have to be done if we wanted the class. That dancer just... We could have done the dancer thing. We could have, she just gave up. She never actually, like... We never killed her. We just beat her up. Where's my teleport stone? I don't feel like walking out. So, after that, we are going to head to Starkward, or, we're in Starkward. We're going to head to, I think, the town, the lava town. I honestly can't remember, I'm sorry. I have trouble remembering some of these names. Oh, no, apparently we're going to the giant ship. Okay, you know what, I'm just going to skip till we get there, so I'll meet you there. Alright, we're here, let's just get to it. You know, I always notice something. When someone comes back from a cut, they always say something like, "All right," or "We're back." Well, of course, "We're back" makes sense, but, like, why is it always saying "All right"? And I've noticed that in a pattern myself, too. I always say "All right, all right, all right," and I don't get it. We need to talk to this guy? Ah, it's a shame. Really, just a shame. Hmm? I'm loud? And irritating? Apologies. Apologies. It's just a shame is all. You see, the little inn in Caldisla I use as my base of operation is, well, it's going out of business. What? Seems the old innkeeper finally succumbed. Poor man can't keep the inn going. What? That guy is as strong as an ox. How can he not keep the inn going? All right, I'm going to go check up on him. I will be right back, guys. Just one second. One second. All right, old man, let's see what's going on with you. Is he going to be okay? Oh, who's this? Oh, okay.
Sick to get up and about, so I'm filling in for him.
He's bedridden? Is it serious?
Not at all. The doctor says he doesn't need to stay in bed, but, well, you should see for yourself.
Well,
Nilo, come here. 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 So, what's going on with him? Is he okay or what?
Having a nightmare.
Aww. It's so sad.
I guess he's become despondent since Owen died.
His son was everything to him.
It must be hard to deal with it alone.
What about that girl? She's related to him, right?
She has to go back to her home soon, I hear.
How do you know that?
Oh, it just came up. Let's check my journal before things take a turn for the worse, hmm? We'll bring the orphan to the inn we set out from. That sounds relevant, no?
Oh, this is the inn we set out from. And the orphan, I guess that means...
Really? But he's already okay. He's already settled in elsewhere.
Mrs. Goodman has given him a good home.
Come to think of it, Eagle's parents were guards. Just like Owen. He said he was raised by his kind grandfather after they died.
What?
It doesn't have to be permanent. Just until the old man gets better. Do you think we could have Egil stay here a while?
I guess that's up to Egil.
Right.
Alright, so we got a plan now. Oh, crap. Do we gotta go all the way back? Oh, god dang it. We gotta go all the way back to the thing, the place with stuff and the lava and the... Glyven! If anyone gets that reference, you're awesome. But yeah, I guess we gotta go back, right? Ah! Alright, I'll be right back. Well, I'll be back when I get there, guys. See you in a bit. So we're here now, and let's see if we can get Eggle to come with us. I mean, it may be a long shot, but hey, who knows?
Hey, you guys! You came to see
me! Actually, we came to take you away.
Hello, Eggle. You look happy.
He's been bouncing off the walls ever since this morning, when he heard you were coming.
He isn't always this way?
No. Since you left, he's been moody most of the time.
Is that true, Abel?
Mrs. Goodman is very good to me. And this place is amazing. But I still want to travel with you.
Hey, Abel. Can I tell you something? It's about a captain of the guard who lived in a far-off land. He died in battle, fighting, to protect his kingdom.
Just like my mother and father.
And this man's
man, all the feels.
He lies sick in bed at the shock of his loss. The captain's father has been of great help to all of us. We owe him a great deal. I was thinking, if you would spend some time with the captain's father, I believe it might help him get better. What do you think?
Why are you even bothering to ask him? Just take him.
If this is Eagle's decision, I won't stop him. But you come back anytime you want, okay?
I will. Thanks for everything, Mrs. Goodman.
Aww. She sounded depressed. I hope she's okay. Alright, party chat. Tiz's thoughts.
Something on your mind, Tiz? You look pensive.
Pensive? Oh, yeah, a bit, I guess.
Thinking about Eggle?
He's just gotten settled at the Goodmans, and now he's being shipped off to a foreign land.
Yeah, there's that too.
That too?
You mean Eleanor, don't you? Yes, the two of them had decided to take him in, and now... they just enough time together to make it painful to part. I feel terrible.
I feel the same. She mustered a smile to see him off, but inside...
Can't be helped, I'm afraid. We can encourage him to write her once he's settled in Caldisla. I wouldn't mind ferrying the boy to the Goodmans every once in a while, either.
Ooh, seconded!
And aren't we forgetting someone here? We brought the boy along on a lot of good intentions and not much planning.
What happens if the innkeeper says no? It all hinges on him.
I might have a backup plan. Let's pay the king a visit before the two of them meet. Oh, alright. Oh, goddammit, now I gotta go back again. Okay, I'll be right back. Alright, time to see the portly king. I'm sorry, that was rude.
That about sums it up. What do you think, Your Majesty?
A fine idea, I must say. I have been concerned about the innkeep myself. Eggle, it is admirable of you to agree to follow in the innkeep's footsteps. The kingdom of Caldisla welcomes you.
You see, I want to be a powerful soldier one day, like my mother and father before me, like Tiz. I want to be a mighty warrior with a kind heart who can protect the ones he loves.
Aww.
Well said, well said. Fine sentiments for a boy to have. Very well, then. You shall be given access to our training hall, Eggle.
Really? Just like that?
And I would be honored if you would accept this gift.
Wow, he's kind of like a king of the people, huh? Really not afraid to mingle amongst the commoners.
A badge we give our young soldiers. My captain of the guard, Owen, also wore one once. This marks you as an apprentice soldier for the kingdom, Eggle. I hope to see you train hard and become a first-rate soldier.
Wow! Thank you!
Thank you, Your Highness.
By the way, Tiz, how is the reconstruction of Narende Village proceeding?
With all your travels to save the world from peril, you must find little time to return, no? Perhaps you could put Eggle here in charge of the reconstruction?
Huh.
Reconstruction?
You would be acting on Tiz's behalf.
I'll do it!
But you're just a kid!
Are you sure you can handle all of this at once? Helping out at the inn, training to be a soldier, and supervising the reconstruction? That's a lot to take on.
No sweat for me!
You have unlimited potential, Eggle. When the time comes, you shall choose your own path. Until then, be fearless and follow your heart wherever it may take you.
Well said.
Thank you.
You know, it'd be kind of cool if in the sequel it featured around Eggle.
Oh, it's you. It's been a while. Ah, you have a young boy with you. And what's this? He wears the badge of a young soldier. That takes me back. My son treasured his above all else. You remind me of him a bit, you know?
I want to be like your son Owen one day. My mother and father were guards as well.
You don't say. I'm sure you'll get there one day.
Man, he just sounds so sad. It's really hard to just, hear him like this.
So you have returned, Vulturnus?
Yes. Not long ago.
I was told you have an urgent report. Can it not wait until the Council of Six convenes?
No. It cannot. It appears the fire crystal has been awakened. The remaining Black Blades continue to fight alongside the Sword Bearers. However, no word has come from Commander Kami Izumi. It seems that morale is plummeting.
Our only option left is an all-out defense of the Earth Crystal. We must cut our losses in that realm.
Jesus, that's pretty heartless.
Forces of the Duchy's First Division?
We have underestimated the Wind Vestal. We shall not make that mistake again. You or I. If the Earth Crystal were to be awakened, there would no longer be hope for this world, and our ideals would fade to nothingness.
But the Wind Vestal has no way of traversing the highlands that surround the Duchy. Only the heavy airships helmed by Arcadre have the propulsion necessary to make the journey.
Do not be so sure. The Wind Vestal has thus far outmatched us at every turn.
This is surprising. This is actually an enemy general or an enemy leader that's taking us seriously.
Summon Victor and Victoria immediately. It seems the Council of Six may have to deal with the Vestal personally.
Wow. He is... okay. That voice, that sounded familiar.
You.
Who was that? That voice sounded so familiar.
I'm glad the innkeep was willing to take in Eggle.
Eggle said he looks so much like his late grandfather, it's scary.
Match made in heaven.
We must go to awaken the Earth Crystal.
But we have no way of entering the Duchy of Eternia.
Perhaps it's time to get out that creepy journal of yours, Ringabel.
Why is it creepy?
I'd hardly call it creepy.
Yeah, I mean, it's been right for so far.
Anyway, I'll see what I can find. There are a few notes that might apply. Earth Crystal, Grand Ship, Engine Room. Those are the words that seem to be coming up.
Grand Ship? Perhaps we'll find a lead.
Maybe. Oh, apparently it's nighttime. Whatever. Well, if we're going to go to If we're going to go to Grand Ship, I might as well just skip there. So, I'll be back. Or maybe I won't be back. Holy crap, side quest available! Side quest. Oh, is that going to be it? Is that going to be the ninja? Oh my god, I hope that's the ninja. I hope I didn't miss it for some reason. Screw Grand Chip, I'm going for the ninja. I'll see you guys when I get there. Side quest, 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 side quest. Come on, be the ninja, 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 ninja. Come on, please be the side quest for the ninja. Please.
I've been expecting you. Thank you so much for what you have done.
Oh, Commander Goodman.
Yeah, why is he at home?
I came as soon as I could when I heard the Wind Vestal was
what?
Holding a banquet in my honor.
A banquet?
My wife is also most pleased. You can see she's all in a bustle getting things ready. I did wonder at seeing the names of officers Steiner
who?
And Neuer on the invitation. How did you know the names of our shield-bearer officers, Vestal? I don't remember introducing you.
Hold on. You've lost me, I'm afraid.
Well, I received your letter saying that you'd like to hold a banquet at my residence.
I have no recollection of sending such a letter.
Is that so? Strange. I'm quite certain.
Was it her handwriting?
Your name.
Never mind that, everyone. The banquet shall be ready soon.
Well, I'd hate to put this food to waste. And Eleanor seems
all right.
So happy.
Indeed.
Wait. It's a trap!
I would be delighted to join you.
This is totally a trap. Oh, this is so ninja behavior. Sneakily killing people. Well, I don't know if it's sneakily killing, but... I don't know, is poison? Fusen? Is the poison? Is the food poison? Oh my god, I'm sorry, I'm so excited.
She may be young, but I hear she's quite capable. They say she's already saved our hides several times.
Allow me to introduce everyone. These are my chiefs of operations. My closest advisors, you might say.
Steiner, Neuer. Those sound familiar. Aren't those the friends of Zatz and Dats? I can't quite remember. It's still kind of fuzzy in my head, but I could have swore I've heard these names before.
Well, now that formalities are out of the
way, I mean, it just like popped into my head. Oh, I thought the game was talking to me.
What is it?
I just opened a letter that arrived this morning.
A letter? There's no sender on the back. Let me see. Daniel Goodman, shield bearer commander.
What the fuck?
Shall die this night.
What on earth? Is this some kind of sick joke? Who would send such a thing?
It came this morning. I think Nastasia, our servant, collected it.
I don't like this one bit.
Well, we veterans should be able to look after ourselves. We should enjoy the peace, Commander Goodman.
All right.
You are right. Are you okay, Eleanor?
Yes.
She doesn't sound okay.
Please accept my apologies for this disruption, everyone.
Not at all. That letter chilled my blood.
A death threat, it seems.
Ring a bell.
Well, it sounds like it. Oh shit, is Eleanor okay? What happened? What happened? She's cringing?
What is wrong?
Something terrible has happened.
Nastasia. Okay. What?
She's dead.
Oh, snap! Okay.
Nastasia is dead. She was not breathing and had no pulse.
We believe a blow to the back of her head with a blunt object is what killed her.
Uh-oh.
But we haven't found a weapon.
We've placed her body in bed for now.
I'm more concerned at the fact
the front door won't open?
It seems to be sealed shut from the outside. We cannot get out.
Can't we just break a window?
I'm afraid not. This residence was formerly a stronghold.
Oh, that seems dangerous.
There aren't any windows on the first floor.
So that means we're trapped?
What on earth is going on? Who killed that servant?
I was preparing the food with Nastasia just before, right up until I opened that threatening letter. I noticed nothing amiss at that point.
What the fuck?
It must have been you who killed her.
Come on, we've gotten to know her by now. There's no way she could.
Why would my wife ever do such a thing?
I have no idea. Perhaps
what?
She was the one who wrote that letter as well.
No, I would never harm a fly.
But you were the only one who could have been with the servant at the time she was killed.
Wait. The
yeah, that's right. Don't you just don't do that.
That said,
oh shit.
The murderer must be among us.
Well, I know us four are pretty safe. Now it's just among these four. I don't think Goodman is the one who said it or did it. So really, that just leaves one of the commanders or officers.
I would never accuse the Vestal, but how can we trust you other three? We know nothing about you. That's just...
I'm sure I appear suspicious. After all, I have no memory and know not my own past.
There's no one who can attest to my background either.
Oh, for pity's sake! Why do you travel with companions of such dubious origin, Vestal?
They show up. All of a sudden, the servant dies.
What the fuck? We're innocent.
Timing a little convenient. Enough. The Vestal and her companions have hardly had time to do such a thing since they arrived. And you well know how much they have aided the shield bearers already. I won't
thank you
to hear the Vestal and her allies insulted. However, in that case, the finger of blame can point only
Goodman, good wife.
Good wife.
Wait. Allow me to take charge of this matter for now. I would ask that you all
Jesus.
Calm.
I guess that includes me. Oh, I guess we can move around now. Alright, well, we're actually out of time for this episode, so the continuation of this next time when we play, let's play regularly default blind. I'm sorry, I'm really wrapped up in this, so I'm having a hard time with the outro. Okay, let's try it. Hope you guys all enjoyed this. If you did, be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe down below. And I will see you guys next time. Bye. Much better.